Hello, today I'm showing you my IBM ThinkPad R51 booting Windows 7 Ultimate 32-bit. Specifications are a 1.6 GHz Intel Pentium M processor, 512 MB of RAM, and a 40 GB hard drive. So let's see how she performs. I didn't shut it properly. I didn't shut it down properly last time, so it just comes up with that. Okay, I put my password in. Takes a while. Every time I start it up, it says this: Windows is not genuine. Your computer might be running a counterfeit copy of Windows. You can go get genuine now or ask me later. So if you click ask me later, comes up with this: it's important to use genuine Microsoft software and adds all the advantages and stuff, so you can just click OK to skip it. You also get the wallpaper disabled, like the desktop background is disabled, and you get a little watermark down there saying it's not genuine. But everything else is normal. That's normal. It's just coming up with some messages. Connected to the internet, the wireless light's on. Just gotta wait for the spinning circle to stop spinning. Okay, here we go. Start. Let's check out system properties. So I have to go start. Well, it's actually not start anymore. It's actually just the all button, or this Windows logo button. It's not start like it used to be on Windows XP. Right click on computer and go properties. It takes a while because it's a piece of shit. Well, I haven't got enough RAM. Okay. Okay, it says Windows 7 Ultimate, copyright 2009. I added the system information, so manufacturer, IBM, model, IBM Windows 7 PC. I don't know why I put that there. Rating, retrieving system rating. Processor, Intel Pentium M processor, 1.6 GHz. Memory, 512 megabytes, 511 usable, it's ripping me off. Operating system, 32-bit, and no pen and touch. I add that to as well. It's just computer name and description. And we just scroll down. And down the bottom it says, piss off you. It's telling me to update AVG, and I can't be bothered. It's just gonna waste more memory, and I haven't got any. Now down the bottom it says, this copy of Windows is not activated. Click here to activate Windows now. Doesn't have like a time limit or anything. The rating. It rated it 2.0. Actually, originally it rated it 1.0. But I hacked into the thingo by watching one of PC Whiz Kids videos, and I changed it to 2.0 just to make it a little bit better. Because the graphics card probably would have given it a 2.0. Alright, processor 4.1, memory 2.9, graphics 2.0, it's actually 1.0. Gaming graphics 1.0. Primary hard disk 3.3, sorry. And yeah, that's the system rating. I hacked it, so originally it was 1.0 for gaming, for graphics and gaming graphics. But the rest was the same. And the processor I changed from 3.1, so I changed it to 4.1. I know, I like to do things like that. I'm an idiot. Let's go on the internet, see how the internet runs. I better hurry up here, or else I'm gonna run out of video. What's this? Go to a homepage for some reason, and drag to the top. And it's gonna show my Hotmail, so I'm just gonna put the camera down. For some reason the address bar goes green. I don't want to show you my Hotmail, so I'm just going to move the camera. And let's go to Google. Okay. Enter. Of course, I get no error. I'm gonna have to use the basic thing. Oh well. I don't really care about error. I just leave everything as default. That's all default. Layers from subscriptions. Let's see. Check my mail. Ooh, one comment. It's probably on my video. I'll look at that later. Go to my channel. If this play thing would scroll. It plays YouTube videos alright, actually. All I do is I just plug in my headphones, and Oh yeah, comment on my new logo and color scheme. Yeah, just wait a second.